thick thighs, thick damage. That's Hutao. Hutao is a popular character known for her powerful pyro abilities and unique playstyle. Today, we will be discussing how to build the ultimate Hutao, from her weapons and artifacts to her talents. This video will provide you with the knowledge you need to build an unbeatable Hutao. So let's get started. Hutao's talents are an important component of building her. The first talent I recommend to upgrade is her normal attack. Majority of Hutao's damage comes from her charge attack that can do massive amounts of damage when used with her elemental skill Guide to Afterlife. This skill allows Hutao to enter the parameter Papilio state, where her max HP is converted to attack, increasing her damage output significantly. It also infuses her basic and charge attacks with Pyro, which cannot be overridden by other elemental infusions, and her charge attacks apply the Blood Blossom effect on enemies hit. Enemies affected by Blood Blossom will take Pyro damage over time every 4 seconds. Hutao's elemental skill's duration is 9 seconds and the cooldown is 16 seconds, and her elemental skill ends if she leaves the field. Last is the new, her elemental burst, Spirit Soother. This skill does massive Pyro damage to enemies in a large AoE. This skill also allows Hutao to heal herself based on the damage she does to enemies, making her a self-sustaining character. And if Hutao's HP is below 50%, the damage and the healing from her elemental burst is increased. Her burst cost is 60 energy and the cooldown is 15 seconds. Hutao's first passive gives the entire team except herself 12% crit rate when her elemental skill ends. And her second passive is a huge one. It increases Hutao's Pyro damage bonus by 30 if her current HP is less than or equal to 50%. All of Hutao's talents are equally valuable and contribute to her overall damage output. So level up her normal attacks and skill first, followed by her elemental burst for maximum damage. Hutao's weapons are crucial to building her into a powerful character. There are a few weapons that are particularly effective for Hutao, depending on your playstyle. The first weapon I recommend is Hutao's best-in-slot weapon, the Staff of Homer. This weapon increases Hutao's maximum HP as well as her critical damage. It also has a unique passive ability that increases Hutao's attack based on her max HP. Another great 5-star option would be the Primordial Jade Winged Spear. This weapon provides Hutao with a significant boost to her critical rate as well as increased attack damage. As for the 4-stars, there are quite a few great options. If you want raw pyro damage, the Blackleaf Pole will be your best option because of its crit damage and the passive increases attack by 12% after defeating an enemy that can be stacked 3 times, followed by the Battle Pass exclusive weapon, Deathmatch. It has significant amount of crit rate and passive that increases attack and defense by 12% if there are 2 or more enemies, or increases attack by 24% if there are less than 2 enemies. The Deathmatch is slightly better than the Blackleaf Pole because of the crit rate and the passive, and if you want to run Hutao in a vaporized focus team, which you should, the best option is the Dragon's Bane. It has a lot of elemental mastery and the passive increases damage against enemies affected by Pyro or Hydro. This weapon is made for vaporize, and if you have the Dragon's Bane at refinement 5, definitely use it, you won't regret it. Artifacts are another crucial component of building the ultimate Hutao. There are a few artifact sets that are particularly effective for Hutao. The first artifact set I strongly recommend is the Crimson Witch of Flames. This set increases Hutao's pyro damage bonus by 15%. It also has a unique 4-piece set bonus that increases pyro damage after using elemental skill and provides her with increased pyro related reaction damage. This artifact set is ideal for an all-round build as it allows Hutao to deal massive pyro damage. Another great artifact set for Hutao is the Shiminawa's Remembrance. This set increases attack by 18%, and the 4-piece set is, after using elemental skill, if the user has 15 or more energy, they lose 15 energy to increase normal, charged, and plunging attack damage by 50% for 10 seconds. This set is good for a charge attack, but you won't be able to use her elemental burst that much as you will continuously lose energy when using her elemental skill, so it is not as good as the Crimson Witch set for overall damage. Mirkosi Hunter set can be a niche choice if you want to run it. It increases normal and charge attack damage by 15%, and the 4-piece set increases crit rate by 12% when the user's current HP increases or decreases. I have not found this set yet, so I can't say if it's good or not, but it's a niche choice nonetheless. And lastly, 2-piece pyro damage and 2-piece HP percent or attack percent or 2-piece Mirkosi Hunter set will also work if you don't have a full Crimson Witch set. And for the artifact stat, you should go for HP percent sands most of the time, but if you want to run her in a vaporized team, you can go for elemental mastery sands only if you are not using the Dragon's Bane. But use the Dragon's Bane and HP sands for vaporize. Trust me, it will output more damage. As for the goblet, pyro damage bonus always, nothing else, and crit rate or crit damage circulate depending on your weapon and stats. Well, that was how to build the ultimate Hutao. I hope you found this video helpful and informative. Remember, building a powerful character takes time and effort, so be sure to experiment with different weapons and artifacts to find the build that works best for you. And you might be making a huge mistake when building your Zhongli. Watch this video to avoid it.